here. About 9 months ago, Rich Salvaggio gave me a call, along with Kim Oldest, and asked me to present a program on party work for AIFD. Very much like a client coming into a shop or coming into your business and asking you to develop a party for them. Maybe with just a little more pressure, right? But it was one of these things. They gave me a lot of freedom, and they said, hey, what do you want to do with this? It's just about parties, but see what you can come up with. And again, we just started with a theme, and I thought, you know, what better thing to do as far as a theme for parties than to use Broadway musicals? How do you think you're going to like that? Be good? Okay, I think so too. So we've decided then to break this into five different parties, and we'll go with these one at a time, but we also wanted to give it a little bit more. We wanted this to be about education. So each party will feature some type of floral education, floral terminology, floral techniques, and some design ideas. And each party will also appeal to one of our sensory modes, either taste, sound, touch, things like that. So we're going to try to go through these one at a time. We have a lot to show. We want the music to be a big part of this, and I really appreciate your coming for this morning. So let's get on to our first party, which is Phantom of the Opera. Okay, and Phantom of the Opera has inspired us. Thank you. Thank you. Isn't that music beautiful? Sarah Brightman has such a beautiful voice in that song, and I thought it would really set the tone and inspire us for doing this party. The musical itself is really all about passion, and it's that very singular, strong passion that the Phantom has for his student, Christine. And in thinking about this passion and in thinking about how strong it was and how single-focused it was, we decided to go with what we would call a monobotanical theme for this. For monobotanical, we're sticking strictly to one type of floral for the entire design. And what we've decided to do was just use all red roses because it's the simplest, most direct approach. And if you're selling this to a client, again, it would be a very natural setting to have for Phantom of the Opera or a party that had that theme. In this presentation, we've done a couple different things. Again, we've started with the very large cylinder vases. Half filling them with water and floating the rose petals about halfway up is just enough to break and to give it weight, but to break the vision line through the table. But it also is not too distracting for many of the people that would be sitting around the table later. We've topped each one of these four cylinders with an arrangement, but grouped them together to make a very large composite arrangement. The roses that we have in here are varieties such as Charlotte, Freedom, Grand Prix, and Black Baccara. We also have the Mimi Scarletta spray roses used in here as well. And then again, to give it more dimension, we've taken the very long pieces of bear grass and just glued the rose petals to the end of bear grass. This is something that could very easily be done at any installation site instead of doing it ahead of time and getting it tangled. If they're done ahead of time, it can just easily be inserted right there. But look how much more volume and look at the dimension that it gives to the table. We have the tablecloth selected and the beautiful chair covers that, again, BBJ was able to lend us for this program, and we really appreciate their generosity. But again, mostly burgundy, staying in those red tones. The table set lightly with the rose petals, almost making a table runner just out of rose petals down the center, with the Phantom mask just laid in between for the guests to have. This party in particular would be just a gorgeous table for two. And this is what I would think maybe the Phantom would do for Christine if he had to have a dinner just for the two of them. The table or the chairs have beautiful chair coverings in gold with bouquets on the back of each one. Again, repeating the look and the lines that we've already started with the arrangements that we have on top of the table. For some of these parties, what I wanted to do was also create something that you could use to divide spaces up. Many of the venue halls that we go to as florists and as decorators need something to break up spaces or divide spaces. So we've made these beautiful cones. How do you like these cones? I have had the absolute best group of people work with me this week. I couldn't ask for anything more. They have worked till midnight on some nights and been back at 7 o'clock in the morning on other days. But the construction of these cones is something I wanted to share with you. They're very lightweight. The base of where it stands is actually all of these materials that we have through the program are either found at a local wholesaler or at one of the major home supply stores or at one of the major chains that's available in almost any town. There is nothing that was really special ordered for this program, so these are looks that can easily be duplicated by any of you. But on these we have the shepherd hooks that are put into the planters are plastic, painted black. We've stacked them with styrofoam inside and then laid some rocks in there to give it some real good weight so that when we put the arrangements on, it wouldn't want to tilt one way or the other. Covered the rocks with rose petals to define the space and to give us a nice, strong color blocking there. But the cones are actually made from wire mesh. It's the quarter mesh material. It's very pliable. You can make a cone very easily out of it and then secure it with either bind wire or aluminum wire. And then stuff styrofoam bits or oasis bits inside the cone just to give it a little bit of stability. We wanted these to be very tapered in shape and very classic, but you can also then mold it. If you wanted something more, you know, that susical look or a little bit more contorted, it could be molded as well. The trick to this is really in the petaling, and petaling can be a very painstaking process, especially for any of you that have worked on the floats or the parade, things that have spent hours and hours. But there's usually that problem with getting the petals to actually stick to the surface you want to put it on. So the easiest thing that we found was we just got rolls of 6-inch tulle and wrapped the entire mesh cone in burgundy tulle. It gave us a nice color background for what we had, but it's the texture of the tulle that holds so nicely to the rose petal with the glue, and you can glue very quickly and very easily with that. On the cones, we've decided to do the Charlotte roses on the outside cones, and we have the Grand Prix rose, I'm sorry, it's the Freedom Rose on the back two cones for the petaling, just so there is a little bit more interest there on color. And then in the top, we've basically taken an 8-inch orb, split it in half, and then made beautiful, beautiful mounds of roses with all the varieties we've used so far. So this again, this is what I think the Phantom would do for Christine.